And I don't want to leave here before everybody in this room either joins the International People's Democratic Uhuru Movement, or ABDEP, or of course the Uhuru Solidarity Movement, which Comrade Harris laid out in a very good way, and which is the first time, literally, in the history of the African Liberation Movement and the general anti-imperialist movement, where the relationship, the correct relationship between white people and the struggles of the liberation of oppressed and colonized people has been defined. Up until the point that the party created the Solidarity Movement, you had white people out here that was trying to lead our struggle for liberation. And they tried to do so as a means of reforming the capitalist imperialist system so that their interests would be met at the expense of our long-term interests of liberation. We saying that even as white people want to see an end to capitalism and do get exploited by the ruling class, and they get fed poisonous drugs, and you know they got contradictions with the white ruling class too. But we saying that the struggle to overturn parasitic capitalism cannot be led by white workers, right? Because we saw why. That man that was driving that train was a white man, and he gets paid very well to drive that train full of our stolen resources, put it on a boat, and take it to Europe, where the white people get paid very well to turn that bauxite into steel that white people now have the ability to drive around in the form of Escalades and Cadillacs and all that, right? So the white working class, so to speak, white people in general do not have the ability. They're not positioned politically and socially, historically, in a place to overturn imperialism and parasitic capitalism. They can't do it on their own. They must function under the leadership of the forces that produce all the wealth in the capitalist system itself, which is African workers, the ones digging up that bauxite, the ones that's working for free in these prisons out here in Pennsylvania, African workers all over the world, and oppressed peoples all over the world. The wealth that's produced by our labor and our resources makes it possible for white people in general to enjoy any kind of social gain, democracy, freedom, and wealth in general. So white people cannot lead that struggle. And if they want to end capitalism, then they must unite with the struggle to defeat and destroy imperialism, which can only be led by the colonized peoples ourselves. Right. And that's how it got to be. And the Solidarity Movement offers up, for the first time in history, the opportunity for white people to take the right stance, to unite under the leadership of the colonized peoples of the world in the struggle to overturn this vicious social system. So with that said, I want to say join the International People's Democratic Uhuru Movement today. And I guess at this point, I'll give it back to the MCs who can tell you how. Uhuru.
Thank you. Already got.